Hello everybody, I'm Nasty Mold, and today's video is filled with beta spoilers. Today we're going to be doing the first and second Season of Remembrance quests. This one is featuring the bereft veteran, and it is genuinely very sad. So yes, let's get started on the spirit story. Again, very, very sad, and it does actually feature some implied death, just as a little content warning. So I do want to start the quest, but I think it would be more beneficial if we really first quickly relive the spirit and kind of watched its spirit memories, because it does have a bit of backstory. So this is where we find the bereft veteran, immediately towards the left-hand side. And I actually do love how they did the stories of these spirits. The fact that it's kind of like a play, it works really well to tell their tales. So here we have the bereft veteran with their child, and they are hanging up a wind chime. You can also see the seasons change on the tree here, and the kid is now going away. So now their child has returned. They're sitting, reading a book. And once they realize their child is back, they give him a big hug, and they have also grown quite a bit at this point. Maybe more like a teenager now. So here we are in the fall, and the child is off to war, presumably, with a spear on their back. Goodbye, Papa. And look how much older they are. Aww. Here in the next part, it is now winter. Much time has passed. And we see it from the father's perspective. So here we are in the house. We hear a knock at the door, and there's someone here. Going down this way. Oop, whoa, whoa. Ruining the immersion of the story. Whoopsie daisy. The father has answered the door, and this person is here with some sort of a note or a letter. Presumably telling them that their child has passed away in the war. Oh my goodness, I'm falling down again. And here in the final scene, we can see the father is now grieving where they hung up the wind chimes. So that is the backstory behind this veteran character. I thought it was pretty important to showcase, and now let's get started on their quest. So what's interesting is that each of these spirits have two quests. I'm not sure if they'll come once every week, or if we'll get two our first week in the live game. I'm not exactly sure how it's going to go, but we're going to do their first two quests today. The bereft veteran longs for something that is gone. Retrieve the lost memory lanterns to help them. The memory lanterns that would bring them peace are lost. Where could they be? Thankfully, they're very easy to find. So for this quest, we just had to fly up to this little meditation spot, sit down, and then find some missing lanterns, and then the quest is complete. So it is pretty easy. These quests are very reminiscent of the assembly quests in that you have to go find and interact with some objects. So for this one, we can find some lanterns along the side. This one gives us the chimes. Then we gotta find the next one. This one is over here. Melting it is a memory of some chairs, So I believe what we're doing right now is we're actually unlocking items to use in the shared space. Here is our final one. Whoop. And this one is a brazier. Brazier? I don't actually know how to say that word. I'm going to say brazier. So our first quest is complete. Let's go turn it in and then get started on our second one. So the Remembrance quests actually utilize the shared space quite a bit, and it works really well to tell the stories they want to tell. I believe this right now is the Remembrance guide, putting the memories of that furniture and those items into the shared space. So now we can start the second quest. This spirit longs for what they have lost. Visit the shared space shrine to help them. Oh, poor fella. Enter the shared space to set it out for them. So now we have to build an environment that will appease the spirit, and obviously we know which item is most important to them, so we have to add that to their shared space. Enter your shared space to start designing. Yep, we are there. And we find the veteran up here. Design a space that eases the spirit's sorrow. Okay, so there is a bug right now where we can't fly while we're in a shared space, so we have to make our way around. And this is why at the moment I can't do the next set of quests, because I have to fly up to get to them. So that quest video won't be out for a while. So we have our featured items, which are the items we found in this area. We can put down the chairs. We also have the wind chime, which is probably the most important item. That is clearly what they want. Hang it there? Oh, we can't hang it there. Hang on. There. The spirit is feeling better. Yay! Save your shared space. Okay. I'm still gonna make it look a little nicer than this, because it's kind of boring. Put some more of those braziers around. Braziers. I want to put these chairs somewhere too, but it won't let me. I guess we'll just settle for some more lighting. Because it's very dark in here. Gotta keep this old fella warm. We'll put one inside. And yeah, that's it. Let's see what else we have. Do I have, like, the fox? No, I don't. I have the cat. Look, that'll make you feel like you have some company. Everyone loves cats. Come on. That'll work. You helped bring comfort to the spirit. Aw, okay, that's good. Let's go complete this second quest, and that is all we can do for now. Oh. There is their child, and they're gasping. Aw, that's sad. So let's see, from that quest, from both of them actually, we have a heart. We can now unlock High Five with the Remembrance Guide, and we have the option to purchase the chime for 30 candles. So I guess let's check out this item, and then we are done. Oh, but first, I actually want to project my space for the bereft veteran, sad face. Because I believe they're up here and you can kind of interact with them, I think. Here they are. Aw, look, it's your little nook. A little better than it was. Not too much better, but a teensy bit better. You have your cute little kitty, you just don't get too close to it. Yeah, yeah. Oh. Let me give you a bow. I wish they'd actually interact with us. That'd be really cool. Or if they could somehow interact with the items you've placed down. That'd be awesome. I'm trying to make the chimes jingle. Where's this guy going? Looking around. Alright, so let's take a closer look at these chimes. I think they're actually very cute. Although, an unnecessary purchase. Only purchase it if you have the extra candles. You can run into them and jingle them. I love that they have some physics. And I'm pretty sure that if you drop them somewhere windy, they'll chime and wiggle in the wind on their own. So let's go to, what's the closest area? Maybe the wind paths? We're just going to drop it at the gate. We're not going to actually go into the wind paths because I am lazy. Even though it's like a couple steps away. Here is the gate. Oh, and we already have the chimes jingling in the rock formation here. Chimes. Oh, so relaxing. So cute. But, yes, that is it for this video. This is for the first and second quests in the Season of Remembrance. I know I've been very much slacking on sharing these quests while they're still in the beta. I used to do it all the time, but I haven't lately. I'll try and get more on the ball on that. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you around. Bye-bye.